Stakeholders in the education sector have threatened to paralyze learning should the government adopt proposals to privatize and commercialize education. Under the umbrella bodies including NAT, KUPET, WASU, KUSU and KUDEHA, the stakeholders claim the move will increase the cost of education and widen the inequality gap. WASU Secretary General Constantine Wesonga says that the Ministry of Education must break its silence following recent remarks by the Trade and Investment Cabinet Secretary Moses Kuria on plans to partner with private investors to improve the status of public universities.
It is forever, for the union makes us strong.
At a stakeholders forum bringing together representatives of education unions held at the Kenya Institute of Special Education in Nairobi on Tuesday, education stakeholders sustained their strong opposition to proposals on privatization and commercialization of education.
You know, investors are interested in making profit. Where will the poor Kenyan family go to? Will they afford university education? Or the government wants to leave education in the hands of the rich only?
This undermines the right to education, entrench and exacerbate inequities, and exploit teachers and education support personnel.
The union leaders were speaking during the launch of a research report done by NAT and KUPET, which revealed glaring gaps in the education sector, which create room for privatization and commercialization of education.
Underfunding to put quality and adequate public school infrastructure, serious teacher shortages, stagnant capitation, and the current unfortunate debate to privatize university education. All the above expose the education sector in Kenya to privatization and commercialization.
WASU Secretary General Constantine Wesonga poured cold water on recent remarks by Trade and Investment Cabinet Secretary Moses Kuria on plans to partner with private investors to improve the status of public universities. Wesonga saying that the unions have resolved to down their tools and paralyze learning should the government adopt any such proposal.
I want to say that Diogo House will speak. Because once NAT is out, KUPET is out, KUDEHA is out, KUSU is out, WASU is out, there will be no learning in this country. And we are not going to leave the management of education to cartels.
The report by the stakeholders recommends that the government should, among others, tame the mushrooming of public learning institutions in the country.
There is need for all education stakeholders to be involved in a national dialogue on the best way to regulate private education providers. Revamp public schools to make them more attractive to parents, learners, and workers.
The stakeholders are now demanding urgent response from the government and quick action to avert the privatization and commercialization in the education sector, something they insist risks widening the inequality gap in the education sector. Safin Achieng Omar, reporting from the Kenya Institute of Special Education, Nairobi County.